Hello, welcome to my channel. In the class 12 previously we have discussed the earth's magnetism and we determined all three parameters with the help of which we can determine the earth's magnetic field at any point at its surface. These parameters are also called the elements of earth's magnetic field. Sometimes the question is asked, write the elements of earth's magnetic field. Then what are these three parameters? Angle of dip, angle of declination and horizontal component of earth's magnetic field. We have discussed in the previous video. Today I have selected some important questions from the board as well as competitive examinations point of view. So stay connected till last of the video, and also before proceeding further, I would like to say please subscribe my channel and press the bell icon. Let us start with the questions written at the board. First question is written that the vertical plane passing through the magnetic axis of a freely suspended magnet. Write the name. We have seen that a magnetic needle or a bar magnet which is suspended freely, then from that axis, if the vertical plane is supposed to be drawn, then what will it represent? In the previous video we have discussed that that plane is called magnetic meridian. So what will be its answer? Geo means earth. You can write geomagnetic or simple only magnetic meridian. Second question says the place where the angle of dip is maximum, minimum. What we have read, if we take the dip needle along the surface of the earth, then we find there are the two points at the surface of earth where the dip needle becomes vertical. Vertical means from the surface of earth it makes 90 degree, and that is the dip angle. Where it becomes, those points are north and south pole. So what is the answer for the first? At the magnetic north or south pole. So at the NM or SM. Where the dip angle is minimum, we have seen that the magnetic needle becomes parallel to the surface. Where? At the magnetic equator. So this will be second answer, at the magnetic equator. Third question, what will be the value of magnetic field at the magnetic north pole? Same, at the magnetic north or south pole, the dip needle becomes vertical. Which pole will be towards the magnetic north pole of the dip needle? Suppose if this question is asked, then what will be your answer? You know, magnetic north pole is near the geographical north pole at the 11.3 degree angle. But you know, inside the earth what is assumed? Hypothetical bar magnet, its south pole is towards that. Then if you bring the dip needle at the magnetic north pole, its north pole will be towards the surface of the earth at that point, and that will be 90 degree. So third question, it is value of BH. BH means horizontal component of earth's magnetic field. Since the dip needle is totally vertical, what will be horizontal component of earth's magnetic field? You know, dip needle is vertical, theta is 90 degree, and what is BH? You know, BH is horizontal component is given by BE cos theta, and cos 90 is 0. So what will be its answer? 0. So in this way, fourth question, come to the fourth question. Magnetic field of earth, its vertical component, it is represented by BV, is root 3 times the BH at a place on the surface of earth, what will be the angle of dip? What is the relation between BV and BH with the angle of dip? We have read that tan theta equal to BV upon BH. You have to remember these relations. Then what will you find? What is BV? Root 3 times BH. So what will you get here? You place BV root 3 BH, BH, BH will be cancelled. Then what will be your answer? That answer will be tan theta equal to root 3. Then it means, if you write here, that this will be tan theta equal to root 3, so theta equal to 60 degree. Come to the next question. Where on the earth's surface BV is 0? Vertical component of earth is magnetic field, earth's magnetic field will be 0. Can you tell where? At the point where the dip needle is totally horizontal. What is that point? At the magnetic equator. So this is the fifth question, that at the magnetic equator the BV will be 0. Now till the five questions we have seen that the value of angle of dip, value of horizontal component of earth's magnetic field and vertical component of earth's magnetic field, how they are related, the questions were based on that. Look the sixth question. A sailor can steer the ship in the direction so as to reach the destination. Which element of earth's magnetic field will he need, he require? So, what is the meaning of question? A sailor can steer the ship in the desired direction. What direction he, suppose he want to go somewhere. So, the sailors in the ship, they in the navigation, what the role of magnetic field, and the question is based on that. He finds that what will be his need, which angle due to which he can steer the ship to attain the destination mark. That is the angle of declination. We have read the angle between both the meridians, geographical meridian and magnetic meridian. So this is the question, that on it is based on the concept that what is angle of declination. Now again seventh question. The angle of dip at a location in southern India is about 18 degree. What you expect, a greater or a smaller dip angle in Britain? You should know, where is Britain in the at the globe? It is near the North Pole. You know what is the latitude of North Pole? That is 90 degree, and Britain has about 70 degree latitude. So it will be greater and the value will be about 70 degree. Come to the next question. This is, in which direction would a compass needle point if placed at north magnetic pole or south magnetic pole? You know, magnetic compass, it can rotate in the horizontal plane about vertical axis. So it will rest, it will point in any of the direction when it is placed at north or south pole, because at the north and south pole the dip needle becomes vertical. And the question is for compass, it will point in any direction. So read the question carefully, that which needle, for which needle the question is asked. Next one, in the magnetic meridian of a certain place, the horizontal component of earth's magnetic field is 0.26 gauss and dip angle 60 degree. What is the magnetic field of earth in this location? This is also very simple, this asked in NCRT also. You know, BH is BE cos theta, theta is the angle of dip. Put the values, you have to find BE. What will be BE? BH upon cos theta. What is BH? 0.26 gauss upon cos theta, cos 60, and it is half, so it will become 0.26 upon 1 by 2, that is 0.52 gauss. In this way, this question will be solved. Now, in the next question, question number 10, write the name of the lines joining the places of equal declination. At the earth's surface, the places which have equal declination, such lines joining those places are called isogonic. So, the isogonic lines. Next part, the lines joining the places of equal angle of dip, they are called isoclinical. So, one word answer is only, so you have to learn that this is isoclinical. And last one, the line of zero dip. Zero dip means dip needle is perfectly horizontal. So, what is the line of zero dip is called aclinic, or it is magnetic equator. You know, angle of dip is zero at the magnetic equator, simply magnetic equator. Now, next question. The horizontal component of Earth's magnetic field at a place is B and angle of dip is 60 degree. What is the value of vertical component of Earth's magnetic field at equator? Look, this is the question. Half of the part is just to confuse you. Most of the students write that the angle of dip is 60 degree, horizontal component of B is B, then what will be the vertical component? There is no use of this 60 degree, because read the question carefully. What is written? What is the value of vertical component of Earth's magnetic field at equator? You know, Earth's magnetic field is totally horizontal at the equator. So, what is the vertical magnetic field? Zero. What is its answer? Zero. Now, the last question. At a certain place, a compass needle points 15 degree west of geographical north. What is the angle of declination at that point? This question defines the angle of declination. You know what is angle of declination? From the true north, whatever is the angle made by the compass needle at any place. What angle is made here? 15 degree. So, this question is saying the definition of angle of declination, that the needle which rests at the angle of 15 degree from the true north. So, this angle is called angle of declination. So, I hope in this way you will read all the questions, you will understand the meaning of the questions, and as per the question, you will give the correct answers. Thank you.